Now that your video is edited, enhanced, and ready to go, it's time to render into a format that you can easily share. For most video tools, including Camtasia, the common file format you'll render your video to is an MP4. Depending on your video editor, there are a number of settings that you can tweak and adjust. I won't get into those in this course, since they are so varied and dependent on your project. There are a few that should be talked about, though. First, before you change any setting, you should think about your end destination. Where will your video live? If you've been watching through all the videos in this course, this is a decision you should have made at the very beginning of creating your video. It's important here again because you may find that your video editing program has an output that will send the video directly to that location. For instance, Camtasia allows output directly to YouTube, Vimeo, screencast.com, and more. Typically, when a program has a predefined output, it will configure all of the settings needed to make it work well at that destination. Most outputs will allow you to add some customized information, like a title, description, or other information. It may also allow you to adjust various settings. If the output allows you to adjust the width or height, make sure that these match the size that you edited your video at. Many of the destinations will not allow you to make this adjustment, but they operate with a default aspect ratio. Meaning, if they expect a 16:9 video, and you create a video with a different aspect ratio, your video will show black bars either above and below, or to the sides of the video when displayed. Of course, you don't need to use one of these outputs to produce your video. You can choose to save your video to your desktop and upload it manually. Before rendering, you'll also want to make sure the file type you're choosing will work with your end destination. I mentioned the MP4 file format above. While I can't guarantee that MP4 videos will work everywhere, it will work in most locations and programs and is the current standard for videos. One of the considerations you need to make when rendering your video is what video player you'll use to add controls to the video. Some programs will create a video player for you, which is a set of HTML, JavaScript, and other information that provide a way to play and pause the video, as well as adjust settings like volume, turn the captions on or off, and make your video play full screen. Video hosting sites like YouTube and Vimeo have their own player to provide these controls. Programs like Camtasia will create a player for you to use, but you need to make sure all of the files created get added to your website for it to work. And different players may provide different options. For instance, if you upload the player from Camtasia with your video to your website, and you added a quiz, table of contents, or a hotspot to your video, it will display just fine. Other players, however, won't know what these additional options are and will be unable to display them. Once you've made your publishing decisions, you can start the rendering process for your video. Know that depending on the length and the content of your video, the publishing process can take a bit of time. The longer and more complex the video, the longer it will take to process. If you feel like it's taking a while, this is usually normal. Once your video is done, you'll want to play the video back. Make sure everything still looks good. Is it scaled correctly? If you used elements like captions, a quiz, or a hotspot, does everything work as expected? If you uploaded to a site like YouTube, do you need to add additional information to make the video more findable? Or maybe to provide information to your viewer? Once everything looks good, it's time to share your video. Next up, let's take a quick look at a few key pieces of data that you may want to look at after you launch your video.